Europe, we have pretty small miners. So for lithium, for example, we have many small miners that needs to feed in to the total need of Europe. On the other hand, if we do it together, for example, with joint forces, build a conversion factory, we have all the potential to build a European value chain.
If you move from batteries to hydrogen, then composites will be absolutely necessary because you cannot make hydrogen tanks without composites.
We are realizing that battery-driven cars are one component, but not the only component, and then we need for fast recharging, for long distance traveling, we need hydrogen, the hydrogen component.
Representing a company like Grundfos in this expert forum, we want to give a message that actually we have a huge focus on sustainability in using these materials, which are very critical in sustainable applications. And with that perspective, actually, we are also having a huge focus on how the sustainability can be implemented in evaluating the critical materials.
I see some important points for heavy rare earth content, which brings the resistance of the magnets to the demagnetization and also to the temperature. So this is, I think, a very important topic, how to maybe reduce the content of heavy rare earth in order to reduce or, let's say, contain the price of the magnets.
The usage and the employ of the aluminum in the last years in the automotive business has been growing steadily because of the features of this material, which is 100% recyclable, with properties that are giving to the automotive designer the opportunity to make lighter components for a longer range of electromobility cars or for reduced fuel consumption in combustion engines application.
Translate the research activities which have been coming up from earlier phases, TRL levels, up to really the industrial phase. So that's really where I see the value of the EIT RawMaterials.
On the one hand, the word risk is right, but there's also the possibility of having this opportunity of the new oil. We have to see that we diversify the supply, and we have a great chance of managing supply within the European Union and establishing a European value chain in terms of raw materials.
Expert Forum on Future Mobility. With more than 250 participants, more than half coming from the industry, we are tackling the grand challenges for Europe's future. These challenges are the batteries and the e-drives for the future mobility.